What if you could heal faster, think clearer, and age slower, all using peptides that your body already understands how to utilize? But here's the problem. It doesn't matter whether or not your body knows what to do if you don't. Peptides are one of the most exciting tools and produce some of the best results in the longevity biohacking space today. Unfortunately, most people don't know that much about them, where to get them, how to use them, dose them, or stack them. They're fragile and require special storage considerations. So I decided to put together a series of videos to address that problem. In this series, we'll cover everything from the fundamentals of how peptides work to how to reconstitute them and inject them safely, from a detailed explanation of some of the most popular peptides and what they do to storage, sourcing, stacking, and cycling, all grounded in real science and in my own real-world experience. Whether you're brand new to peptides or you've been experimenting for a while now, this series is designed to get you up to speed with everything you need to know to successfully navigate the peptide space. Now, in this first video, we're laying down the foundation. I'll break down what peptides are, how they actually work in the body, and their similarities and differences from hormones. We'll look at the major categories: healing, cognition, metabolism, longevity, people are using these compounds for. I've been using peptides personally for a few months now, and I've tested about a dozen different compounds. I've seen real results, and I've learned a lot in the process. So I decided that it's time to share what actually works and what to watch out for. So let's start with the basics. What the hell are peptides? They're short chains of amino acids linked together like beads on a string, usually somewhere between 5 and 50 of them. Now, if that sounds familiar, it's because amino acids are also the building blocks of proteins. But peptides are smaller, they're lighter, and they act like messengers in their primary role. Your body already makes hundreds of peptides naturally. They're involved in everything from wound healing to brain signaling to metabolic control. They're like biochemical text messages telling cells what to do, when to do it, and how intensely to respond. What we're talking about in this video and in this series are synthetic peptides, lab-made versions that mimic or amplify the peptides that your body already produces. But even though they're synthetic, your body treats them as natural. That's because they're familiar signals that your biology already knows how to read. It does this through receptors. And these synthetic peptides don't require new or special receptors. They work by binding to the exact same receptors your natural peptides already use. So you're not forcing anything unnatural into the system. You're just leveraging the body's existing communication infrastructure, sometimes with a little more power and a bit better results than what nature built in. And unlike pharmaceutical drugs, peptides don't try to override your systems. They enhance internal communication, guiding your body to repair faster, function better, or age more slowly, depending on which peptide you're using. Now, peptides are signaling molecules. They tell your cells what to do by binding to specific receptors and triggering a biological response. That response might mean speeding up tissue repair or reducing inflammation. It might be supporting brain function or enhancing the activity of the mitochondria. It all depends on the specific peptide. So, in that sense, peptides are kind of similar to hormones. Both act as messengers inside the body. But that's where the similarities end. There are key differences in how they're made, how long they last, and how broadly they affect the body. Hormones are produced in glands, like the adrenals or the thyroid. They get dumped into the bloodstream, and they broadcast their signals across multiple systems. Hormones like testosterone, cortisol, insulin don't affect just one tissue. They affect many with wide-reaching effects. Because of that broad reach, hormones are tightly regulated by the body. They're controlled by feedback loops. And when you start introducing hormones from the outside, you risk throwing off that balance, sometimes badly, and possibly suppressing their own natural production. Peptides don't work like that. They're smaller, short chains of amino acids, like I said, usually 5 to 50 long, and they bind to specific receptors, triggering specific actions. Usually, they're broken down very quickly by enzymes in the bloodstream, which limits how long they act and how far their effects spread. That means peptides are more precise, more localized, and in many cases, safer. instead of overriding your biology, they nudge it. They help to activate what's already built in, just more directly. So yeah, peptides and hormones are both messengers. But peptides give you more control, less systemic risk, and cleaner results when they're used properly. And quite frankly, that means you got to know what you're doing. That's why I put together a group coaching program that's all about peptides. And it'll kick off later this month, probably around the week of the 14th. We'll cover what all the peptides are and what they do. We'll cover sourcing, reconstitution, stacking, dosing, and we'll do it all in 6 short weeks. The program is hosted inside my free school group, the Longevity Alliance. Now, if you'd like to learn more, I've put a link in the description that'll take you to the sign-up page for the community. Once you've signed up, go to the classroom and look for the Primer on Peptides group coaching program. Okay, now that you know what peptides are and how they work, let's look at what they're actually used for. Now, this isn't a complete list. There are dozens of peptides and a lot of overlap in how they're categorized, and I'll get into that in a future video. But this will give you a generalized introduction into how peptides are used and for what. Healing peptides are some of the most popular. BPC-157 and TB-500 are two of the big ones. They help speed up recovery, reduce inflammation, and support soft tissue repair. Things like ligaments, tendons, and the gut lining. ARA is another with anti-inflammatory and nerve regenerating properties. Now, I've personally found it can really help with symptoms of peripheral neuropathy when combined with red light therapy. If you're dealing with chronic pain, injury recovery, or even post-surgery healing, these are worth taking a look at. Now, cognitive peptides like Celanc and CMAX are used to improve focus, reduce anxiety, and support brain health. They can be taken nasally or by subcutaneous injection. Both work, but many people find that the injectable form is more consistent. These are effective when you're under a lot of stress, when you're working really hard, or when you're trying to stay mentally sharp while under a lot of pressure. Metabolic peptides help with fat loss, energy, and performance. MOTC and 5-amino-1-MQ are two that support mitochondrial function and glucose regulation. They can help with body composition, endurance, and metabolic flexibility. Now, longevity peptides target cellular aging. Epitalon is known for its effects on telomere length and circadian rhythm regulation. FOXO4-DRI is an experimental peptide that targets senescent cells, those zombie cells that have stopped dividing but don't die. They're all very still in the early age, but they look promising. There are aesthetic peptides like GHKCU that can stimulate collagen production and tissue remodeling. You'll find these in high-end skin serums, but they're also used in injectable form for more systemic or targeted skin regeneration. There's sexual function peptides like PT-141. It enhances libido and arousal in both men and women. Kisspeptin is another. It supports natural hormone production and can be part of a broader hormonal optimization plan. Now, like I said, we'll go deep into these in future videos. Mechanisms, stacks, dosing, safety, all of it. But this should give you a solid overview of what peptides can do and where they fit in. Now, I get it. That's a dozen peptides that I just took a really brief look at. And that's just barely scratching the surface. That's exactly why I put together a free resource to help you get started. It's called the Longevity Peptide Toolkit. Now, this is a cheat sheet that breaks down exactly how to use each peptide. How much lyophilized peptide powder is in each vial, how much bacteriostatic water should be added to reconstitute it, how much solution to draw into a needle, how big a dose, how often to dose, everything you need to know. Just click on the link in the description. Now, there's another link on that page that will take you to my online peptide calculator. This calculator will tell you exactly how many units you need based on the amount of powder, the amount of water, and the size of the dose. Between the peptide toolkit and the calculator, you'll have everything you need to get started with peptides, except the peptides themselves. Now, before you go ordering any peptides, let's talk for a minute about the legal landscape. Most peptides are sold in the US as research chemicals. That means they're technically legal to buy, but not FDA approved for human use. So you're operating in a gray zone here. That also means no regulation on purity, safety, or accuracy on the amount. And That opens the door to shady operators, companies that underdose, mislabel, or straight up sell you something that's not what it claims to be. So do not buy peptides from Telegram groups or sketchy Reddit threads. Just saying. Okay, this video was just the foundation, the what and the why. In the next video in this series, which will probably be in 3 or 4 weeks, we'll be getting hands-on. I'll show you exactly how to reconstitute a vial, how to draw and give a sub-Q injection. We'll be covering dosing strategies like microdosing, which is really producing some great results. We'll talk about cycling, so you don't build resistance to peptides, and so that you can use a wide variety of beneficial peptides. Now, I just want to say right here that I'm not a doctor and I'm not recommending that anyone take peptides or really any medication or protocol. I'm simply relating my own experiences and what I've learned along the way. But if you enjoyed this video and you'd like to see more videos in this series, let me know or leave a comment or go over to the communities tab and join the conversation on peptides. Let me know what you'd like to see or learn, and I'll do my best to include it in future videos. One last thing to leave you with. Next weekend, I'll be at RadFest in Las Vegas at the Red Rock Resort. RadFest is the Revolution Against Aging and Death Festival, and it's one of the biggest and longest running longevity festivals going. I'll be giving a presentation on Saturday morning, July 12th, in the 65 and Beyond breakout room on the most powerful intervention for reversing biological age. If you're at RadFest and you see me, come up and say hi. I'd love to meet you, get to know you, have a conversation. And if you have time, check out my presentation. Okay, that's it for me. I'm out of here. Don't forget, if you're interested in my group coaching program, Primer on Peptides, head over to school.com, join the Longevity Alliance, and sign up. Catch you next time.